Right, guys. Time for the review on the Empow Petrol headphones. Now, you remember I unboxed these, about 2 weeks ago now? And I have to say, they're pretty good, actually. There's only one real sort of thing that I would consider to be maybe a bit of a flaw, but you can sort of get by with it. So yeah, they're all plastic construction. And they've got like these little stabilizers on them. Now you get two types of stabilizer. Now the strange thing is you only get one pair of these ones, one size. And I found these ones a bit soft. Now they're actually described as an indoor sport sort of stabilizer thing, these. And they're just that bit too soft. I found, you know, where once you start to sort of whip your hair back and forth a bit, they tend to come a bit loose, I find. And of course, once you throw a bit of sweat into the mix, then, you know, they're not that good. The other ones, however, which are described for more of your outdoor sports, and these are the ones that are like full of like the perforations to give them like a stealthy sort of look. They're actually really good. Now I've got the smallest set on, I believe, and that was the one, or is it? No, I'm telling a lie. This is the next size up, and you actually get three pairs of these. A small one that's a bit smaller than this. This is the mid-sized one, and then there's a larger one. Now obviously everybody's ears are different, so. But this actually fits nicely into the curve of your ear. I mean, that is the left one, so that would go in my left ear, and you can see that just comes up above and would just sit into this part at the front of your ear here. So, and I've got the smallest buds on. Now you get three sizes of buds. These are the smallest ones. The next ones up were just that little bit too big, became a little bit awkward pushing it into my ear hole, basically. You know, I mean, the plastic construction doesn't bother me at all. It's actually a really nice finish on them. And they've got this handy dandy clip here that clips that flat cable in. So if I just, where are we? Yeah. So if I just take that out of there, and then you'll also see that you've got this pair of little black. Let me just come in close and see if I can get that to focus a bit up. You can just see the grooves in there that you wind the cable through, and you've got one there, and that's just so that you can shorten them, you know, and you can have them at the front or behind the head like that. And it's fully integratable with Siri and all the rest of it like that. You've got the control here, which is difficult to see with it all being in black silicone coating. Microphone, pretty much the same as any other one. You tend to find that when you sort of start moving around a bit and what have you, you need to sort of hold it and sort of focus it towards your mouth for people on the other end to hear the call that you're taking. Other than that, they're really great. Sound wise, if you're all about the bass, forget them. They're not tinny by any means. They just haven't got a lot of bass. I wouldn't say they're lacking, because sound-wise, you actually get a really good, clear sound right through the range, to be honest. It's good at the top and good at the bottom. I've not had any problems with that, but they're just not heavy on the bass, but not so little on the bass that you would call them tinny. And then we move on to the one and only thing that I'm not happy with about them. Now, somebody actually complained they didn't know which end to take off. that I read somewhere. Somebody complained that they didn't know which of these caps to remove to charge it up. And what it is, it's actually, obviously, the one nearest to this. And what it is, it's got this tiny little, I'm going to insert some more footage here, actually, to get it close. I took some macro footage. And what it is, there's like a little nick that you take out, and a man especially is going to struggle to get his thumbnail under it, and he's going to struggle to get possibly even the next one along under it, and it's just awkward to open it. It's and that is the only downside for me. I just really struggle. Thumbnail, I can't get it under. Next one along, I can sometimes, but the next one along after that, I get it off straight away. So that is, it's just fiddly. It's just annoying. It wouldn't put me off buying them, but it is annoying that you have to do that. So they could really do with implementing something a bit better there. Maybe a lip lower down on the chrome part, just something that you can actually get your nail under and hook it out. Two hours for a full charge, and 5 hours, roughly. That's what it states, and it's roughly correct. The other thing that they can maybe do is put a bag in the box. It could be that the one in, if you actually buy them, remember these are for review purposes only, but it doesn't say anything in the paperwork anywhere about you getting a bag, so there may not be one in. So anyway, guys, I mean, leave your comments underneath, you know, let me know what you think of the sort of thing that you buy, use. You know, there will be a full written review on my website. That'll be up shortly, and that's pretty much it, guys. Make sure you do check out their website as well, by the way. They've just started doing a weekly giveaway on their website. The buy links are all through Amazon .com, so it's US. I haven't as yet found an Amazon UK link for them. If I find one, there will be one under the video. If not, it will be only the US link, I'm afraid, guys. So, you know, that's the way it goes. But for the money, I think they're great. So that's it, guys. Leave your comments underneath. Let me know what you think. Cheers, guys. See you next time.